Good afternoon. Welcome to Grain TV. It's August 13th, 2014. I'm Logan Burgess. To my right here is Cody Bills to help break down once again a mixed trade in Chicago for the grains. Jumping into the quotes here, we had corn up 0.75 cents, soybeans moving lower by 12.75 cents, and we had Chicago wheat continuing to move lower as well, down 5.75 cents. If you guys haven't taken a look at our mobile trading app yet, visit us over at grainhedge.com. You can take a demo there of 14 days and get live quotes on your iPad, iPhone, Android, or tablet. As always, if you have questions, call the office, 877-472-4607. Turning our attention here to the markets, though, Cody, once again, we saw strength out of corn, weakness out of the soybean complex. Was it just follow through from yesterday's number, or were other factors at play here today?
Well, it sure did look like it. You know, you look at soybeans trading lower here. That was the bearish number. When you look at corn kind of hanging in there, but nothing really positive. I think that was the overall tone of the report here yesterday. This morning, we did have some new crop sales here, 130,000 metric tons of new crop corn going to unknown destinations. We saw 107,000 of new crop corn going to Mexico here. So those are very positive. But we also had ethanol come out today. We saw ethanol production raised to 931,000 barrels per day here. When you look at this chart, which shows the kind of seasonal production here in terms of 1,000 barrel per day, what you're seeing is that the purple line, which is right up around that 931,000, is very seasonally strong relative to history. So this is strong ethanol production. This is very strong corn demand. And I think that's kind of a theme that we saw here today, strong from export sales and strong from ethanol. When you look at the stocks here, we did get a decline in stocks. We're down to 17.76 million barrels here. That's off 500,000 barrels.
So following here, the USDA report, Cody, 2 days of relatively strong gains for the corn market, or excuse me, relatively strong price action, but relatively small gains on actual cents per bushel basis. Mm-hmm. Do you think this could be the start of a turnaround here for corn, or are people just kind of treading water here at the moment after yesterday's number?
Well, one thing that is not being debated is the fact that this is an enormous corn crop. These are record yields. And I think right now, the USDA didn't come out as high as you would expect, but I think they're most likely going to get there. The bottom line, though, is we didn't get the number that really fuels that selling pressure. And I think without that significant number to fuel the selling pressure, I think people are short this crop. That's not a surprise. I think really when you see these strong demand numbers, it does provide an environment where you may get a little bit of short covering. Do I think the overall trend has changed? No, we're most likely going to go lower here, but this may provide a little bit of an opportunity to pause and maybe even gain a little bit of ground, something we haven't seen in quite some time.
Yeah, you know, it seems like a different story though when we're looking at soybeans. Today we did see some continuation of yesterday's move. If you take a look here at the daily November soybean chart, as you can see, that yellow line is the price level we highlighted yesterday at 1055 there. We've now broke this area of support, and right now it clearly looks like a market that is making lower lows and lower highs as well. With today's move, as I highlighted yesterday on the show, the next area of key trendline support is right around $10 per bushel. So based on the fundamentals right now, based on that 15 million bushel surprise for 2014-15 ending stocks we got yesterday, in my opinion, we are going to come down here and test $10 by harvest. One thing that could slow down the selling pressure, in my opinion, though, is the weather outlook here over the next 6 to 10 days. We know that we have a reemergence of drought conditions out in South Dakota, Nebraska, kind of that western corn belt. And you can see looking at the precipitation match that there is not a great probability of seeing good moisture events out there over the next 6 to 10 days. That could be a concern here for the soybean market. But as I said, based on the technical landscape right now and based on the fundamentals yesterday from the USDA, wouldn't be surprised if we saw some continuation here and go down and test that long-term trend support.
Absolutely. And keep in mind that we do have NOPA crush numbers out on Friday. We have export sales out on Thursday. We'll be tweeting about those as well. You can follow us at Grain TV on Twitter, or you can follow us on Facebook. Thanks a lot for tuning in today. Remember, if you have any questions about what you saw, give us a call at 877-472-4607. Thanks a lot. We'll see you here Thursday.